The Birth of a Nation shot was much more complicated than you might think, because really Tom is the only new piece of footage in that particular scene. It's just him. We shot it in Will Rogers State Park, and so Tom was in makeup on a horse. As he rides away from us, what I had to do was look at that old footage and try to guess how high do I think the camera is above the ground. Guess how far away Tom has to be from camera so he's riding in front of the group, which is all, you know, decades earlier, and just how does that all mesh together?
So we start out here with our original photography in full color, and we're trying to end up in a place that's as close as possible to the framing of the Birth of a Nation footage. Picked similar lighting, similar kind of texture on a dirt road with Tom Hanks going through his actions.
That was just the shooting on the day. All the other stuff that it was incorporated in that is degrading Tom's image so it looked like all the stuff from the original footage, which was in pretty bad shape. We started off, it's supposed to be a still of Tom, so we did all this paintwork to look like an old photograph, because that's what we're looking at first, and then that starts moving, and then that sort of introduces you into the scene.
And gradually animated into bringing up the grain and the moving footage, and all of this is just the treated original element, and then at a certain point here we start splitting in the tracked ground from the Birth of a Nation footage, and we've had to rotoscope Tom on top of this and split in the old footage.
One of the things that we were fascinated with is because the original footage has tire tracks on the road from the camera vehicles and stuff from D.W. Griffith, well, we didn't want to tamper with that, so we left that there. It's still in the shot.
Now, when I was a baby, Mama named me after the great Civil War hero, General Nathan Bedford Forrest. She said we was related to him in some way, and what he did was, he started up this club called the Ku Klux Klan. They'd all dress up in their robes and their bed sheets and act like a bunch of ghosts or spooks or something. They'd even put bed sheets on their horses and ride around. And anyway, that's how I got my name, Forrest Gump.